Female book characters from books that I have read and reviewed as 5-star books. These are some of my favorites of all time, and I was so excited to draw some of my favorite characters for them. I'm also going to be talking a lot about books in this video, so if you're a book nerd like me, you might enjoy it. This first book is 1,000 Splendid Suns by Khaled Hosseini. I don't know if I pronounced his name right, but I think that's about right. This book basically follows this Muslim woman and her journey through, like, she lives in Afghanistan, I think, and it was just very rough, and it just follows her story. Reason why I love this book so much is because it's very, very sad, and I almost cried during third block in English when I finished it because it was just very sad. But this main character named Maryam is very strong, and she's just a very well-rounded character, and I just loved her morals, and that's why I chose to draw her. This book was definitely out of my comfort zone since I normally read fantasy and dystopian, and this one was realistic fiction, like historical fiction, so it was definitely out of my comfort zone, but it was worth a read because it got me out of reading block. And I don't know, it was just a very good book, definitely different. It introduced me a lot more to Islamic cultures because I was just not very informed about that, like Islamic cultures as a kid, because I've never like grown up around there. So I don't know, it was very good. I would recommend it. But yes, it is very sad. So if you don't like sad books, I want to read it. Another thing I would like to talk about is my posting schedules. I know I've been very inconsistent, but that's because I've been trying to balance school, sports, and arts, and extracurriculars, and it's just been a lot, especially since I don't get home till like sometimes 6 every night, and then I have to still do homework, and then go to bed and shower and all that stuff. So it's definitely very, very hard, and just, I don't know. It was very hard to balance all that stuff, but now I'm done with my fall sports, so hopefully I can draw a bit more and hopefully post a little bit more. I have been posting more on Instagram, so if you guys want to go check me out there, I have been trying to be a little bit more consistent. I also tried to pick books that are a little bit more diverse for this because I just wanted, I don't know, a bit more diversity in my drawings, since I feel like a lot of times I just do draw like pretty white girls. I just wanted to draw, like, I don't know if that makes sense, just more diversity, more culture in my art. So here's the finished product for the first drawing, and I hope you enjoyed it, and definitely go check out 1,000 Splendid Suns. It was a really good book. The next book I have is Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo, and this is maybe my favorite book of all time. Or correction, it is my favorite book of all time. I absolutely adore this book, and it's just overall amazing. It's just such a good book. I love it with all my heart. The character I'm drawing is Inej Gaffa. She is the most incredible female character I think I've ever read. She is just overall amazing, and I did not do her justice with this drawing. I do not like this drawing of her, and I wish I would have done better, and I might try to redo it one digitally, and I might post it later. But seriously, this book, this series, Six of Crows, is just an amazing series, and you should totally read it because it's totally worth the hype. It's amazing. Basically, this story is about these 6 main characters who have to go on this heist to stop this, like, lethal drug that's gonna go around, and they go on this heist, but they're kind of the bad guys, but kind of the good guys. It's kind of confusing. They're kind of just their own little gang, and it's amazing. It's so good, and everybody should read it. And if you don't like reading books, at least watch the Netflix series Shadow and Bone. It's pretty good. The book is still better, though. I seriously don't like this drawing, though, and I don't even know why. I think it's something with the lips, maybe, that I didn't like, or maybe the facial proportions. Maybe I smushed her face too much. But I just, something about it just didn't scream an edge to me, and it was a little disappointing, especially since I absolutely adore this book, but it still didn't ruin the book for me because I absolutely love this book so much. There's nothing wrong with it. It's like the most perfect book This voiceover is such a mess. Oh my goodness. I'm like out of breath because I just worked out, and then I'm like, let me go record a YouTube video. So I'm like, hey guys, today I'm talking about book characters, and I didn't even write a script, so I don't even know what I'm talking about. But I'm just winging it because I need to post something, and this is like a filler, but every video now is a filler because I don't even know what I'm doing at this point. And oh wow, look at all the smudging I'm doing with my coloring because I brushed this so bad. I'm just kidding, hopefully it's not that bad of a video, but yeah, okay. Good news, I'm almost done with my sketchbook. I have like 3 pages left, so a sketchbook tour should be coming out soon. And so should a starting my new sketchbook should also be coming out soon. And I think that will be really fun. Also, if you guys would comment your favorite books down below, if you are like book people like me, that would be really cool. Because it's always nice to find somebody else out there who likes books as much as I do. Because I love books a lot. My bookshelf is overflowing. Like, I had to stack books so many different ways. And then I have a giant stack of books on top. And it'll probably fall over. And then I have a whole drawer full of books, too. It's kind of a mess right now. And I really do want to build myself a bookshelf or buy a bookshelf. But they're kind of expensive. And so I'm just working with it and stacking books as much as I want. And here is the end result for Nej. She is just, oh, the best character ever. Like, seriously, I love her so much. Next book I have is An Ember in the Ashes, but I only have the 3rd and 4th, like, book in the series. So here's the 3rd book, A Reaper at the Gates. And I absolutely adore this series as well. It is so amazing. Like, Sabaa Tahir is maybe the best author I've ever read. She's just absolutely amazing at writing. Like, her writing style is everything I aspire to write like. It's everything I want. So the character I'm drawing today is Helene. She is actually the Bloodshrike, and she goes by the Bloodshrike in the later books, but her name's actually Helene. And she is the most morally strong character I think I've ever read. Her morals and like how strong she sticks to her beliefs is insane. And all the trauma that she has to go through and how she handles it is also crazy. Like, just, she's such a strong character, and I don't know, something about that just is so cool to me. I wish that my characters were as developed as she was, and that's something I'm trying to work on, trying to just make a really developed character who knows everything going, like, you know every single detail about them, you know? So that's kind of how I feel about Helene. She's just so developed and so great. Also, y'all want to talk about inconsistent styles, because my style right now is all over the place. I will make drawings that look like these, but these actually are not my favorite drawings. I've made different drawings, especially at night. I draw a lot of good drawings at night, and they're just overall really good drawings, and I like them a lot, and I wish that, I don't know, I'm just trying to figure out my coloring style more, because I love how I sketch things, and then when I start to color them, they just look way different. I really like how I drew Helene, though. She just turned out very good. I did use a reference for this of, like, what, like, she's supposed to look like compared to, like, the book cover. I used a different reference on Pinterest, but I think it really suited her, and that's kind of how I imagined her throughout the series anyway, so I used that instead. Also, I don't know how much I'll be posting in the future. Like, I'll try my best, but right now I've been just insanely busy. Obviously next summer will be fine and I'll post as much as I did this summer, and hopefully over maybe Christmas break I'll be posting some Christmas videos, and hopefully I'll post an animatic sometime soon. But other than that, I'll try to post when I can, but just don't be expecting anything, because I don't know. We'll just see what happens and see what happens when the time comes. But most of the time, I have sports games and I don't get home until 10 o'clock that day, and I still have to catch up on homework. So most of the time, I just don't have much going on. On weekends, I'll try to do things, but still, I still have some basketball games and stuff on weekends. But overall, I really was proud of how this drawing turned out. The spread was okay. It wasn't my favorite thing, but I just wanted to sit down and draw again, and here's how the finished drawing turned out, and here's how the finished spread turned out. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and hopefully I'll be posting more in the future, but just know I'm not dead. I'm still here. I'm still watching your guys' videos, but anyway, see you guys later. Bye.